decimals.
Let's talk about adding and subtracting decimals. When we add and subtract decimals, line the decimals up. +1.329. I do not line up off of the right, I line up the decimal. So when I rewrite this problem, these decimals are like a supporting wall of a house. They do not move. You keep them all nice in a row. Even though this one is shorter in length, it doesn't line up like this. This is wrong. It looks nicer because we rounded up, we lined it up off of the right, but it's incorrect. The decimals line up when we add and subtract. Now, when you do have an empty spot like this, it is backfilled with a zero. So let's add this. 0 plus 9 is still 9. 6 plus 2 is 8. 2 plus 3 is 5. My decimals are lined. 4 plus 1 is 5. If I was to subtract, this one is on top, this one's on back. Again, I'm going to line up off of the decimals. Backfill my missing number for zero. My numbers and decimals are all columnized. Keep it nice and neat. So when we go to subtract, well, 0 minus 8, I can't do. So I'm going to go next door and borrow a 10, which is going to make my 9 into an 8. My 0 becomes 10. 10 minus 8 equals 2. 8 minus 6 is a 2. Again, I have to go next door and borrow, so my 3 becomes a 2. My 2 becomes a 12. 12 minus 3 is 9. Decimals stay nice and lined up. 3 minus 0 is still 3. Adding and subtracting decimals, you line the decimals up. However, when we talk about multiplication, this is where it differs. We do line up off of the right. We line up to the right, not by the decimal. So, 8 to 8 gives me 64. I write the 4, I carry the 6. 8 to 9 gives me 72. 72 plus 6 gives me 78. I write the 8, I carry the 7. 8 times 2 is 16, plus 7 is 23. I write the 3, I carry the 2. 8 times 3 is 24, plus 2 is 26. I write 26. If you've not noticed, right now I'm ignoring any decimal. I had the 8, I started straight below. I'm moving over to the 1, I start straight below. So here's where the first number. 1 times 8 is 8. 1 times 9 is 9. 1 times 2 is 2. 1 times 3 is 3. Still ignoring the decimals. I add down. So 4 plus 0 is 4. 8 plus 8 is 16. Carry my 1. 1 plus 3 is 4. Plus 9 is 13. Carry the 1. 6 plus 1 is 7. Plus 2 is 9. Nothing to carry. 2 plus 3 is 5. It is at this point that I'm going to worry about the decimals. I see 1, 2, 3. How many decimal places are there? It's the number of the numbers to the right of the decimal. I see 3. Here's my decimal. I see 1, 2. 2 decimal places. It's the numbers to the right of it. Together, they make up 5 decimal places. This is where the decimal comes into play. I am moving it in 5 places. So I go from here's where it starts. I see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So my final answer would be 0.59364. Now, if you watched the previous video, if it said round to the nearest tenth, I look at the 5, I look at the 9. The 9 tells me the 5 rounds up. So my final answer would be 0.6 if I round to the nearest tenth. Okay? If we're talking division, okay? One truly cannot divide by a decimal, so we have to get rid of it. And how do we get rid of it? We move it. If I move it on the outside, I need to move it on the inside. So my real problem becomes this. I move it on the outside, I move it on the inside. Now, does 3 go into 1? No. Does 3 go into 14? Yes. 4 times. 4 times 3 would be 12. I subtract. I drop the 5. 3 goes into 25. 8 times. 8 times 3 is 24. 25 minus 24, 1. I drop the next one. I have 3 going into 12 4 times. I'm done. If I needed to go further, I would add it a 0, keep going. But my final answer, the decimal's here, I bring it straight up. So my final answer would be 48.4. So when 0.3 divides into 14.52, it goes in 48.4 times. Now, if you need to practice on this, please, on the webpage, see the attached link that has a worksheet in there. Answers are included. Print it, try it, check your answers. If you need further help, there are plenty of videos out on the internet. And I will be adding more to this. Good luck.